Okay, so today we're going to be talking about how tokenomics impacts business management. For all the impressive automation and disintermediation potential that blockchain has to offer, the range of opportunities that will be totally automated and decentralized are going to be very limited and probably short-lived. The majority of successful and long-lived blockchain businesses will not run themselves. They will still need active human executive direction and human labor for their operation. And to be successful, humans tasked with these responsibilities need to be able to make the right calls as often as possible. Skills that depend on your view and understanding of the business. But it turns out that tokenized businesses are often quite different to conventional ones. And this can pose significant knowledge gaps for seasoned managers and executives. Blockchain is still a very young space, and most senior business talent has developed their experience managing businesses outside of blockchain or in areas that are very narrowly focused on trading and other investment-related activities. Unfortunately, sometimes these knowledge gaps are only noticed after management's hands are tied or after they've been blindsided by unexpected events. As I've progressed on my own learning journey through my advisory experience, I've come to see that clients benefit from some active coaching that helps to make them aware of how tokenomic issues can affect their management practices. So that's what we're going to set our focus on for today. I'll be sharing a high-level introduction to some of these issues that I've seen come up repeatedly. And in that process, we'll also make progress towards this larger task at hand of understanding what tokenomics is and how it's relevant to business. Let's begin with a representation of a standard digital product business. This is an appropriate reference because the process and economics of production are similar for the development and commercialization of blockchain-based products. This representation breaks down a business into its key functional areas, something you'll recognize from the departmental organizations and companies you may have worked for, or from management training that you may have received. What we're going to see is that tokenomics can have an impact on a full 4 out of these 5 key business areas that are being illustrated here. Understanding these interactions are going to be important and even critical to you as founders and managers to make sure that you are getting the full picture on your business, manage these areas appropriately, and ask the right questions of your tokenomics experts and specialists. We've seen how bad tokenomics can compromise value preservation and accumulation for users, but it turns out that bad tokenomics can also sink a project from within by compromising its capacities for effective financial management. This would be quite a deep and detailed area to delve into, so I'm just going to give a high-level view here of some of the key and commonplace issues I've encountered. First, any and every business has to have a clear handle on its revenue processes and how these proceeds cover ongoing expenses. In a tokenized business, however, the chances are that some of these revenues will be driven by token-related activity, which occurs in a manner that's determined by specific parts of a tokenomic design. And this presents us with issues and questions that are uncommon or outright alien to traditional management concerns. First off, it is key to understand whether the revenue is generated through the sale of proprietary digital assets or through the collection of fees related to some service. These have very different margins and implications for revenue risk and scaling. Next up is understanding value capture is conveyed by a project's native token or by some other established and highly liquid crypto asset like BTC or ETH or a stablecoin. These choices are incredibly consequential for the operational expense coverage and treasury management of that business. When you are not collecting value in stablecoin, you're exposing the business to some serious token value risks, and your opportunities for hedging these risks are still very limited. In conventional cross-border business operations, you could take out special swaps and derivatives to manage foreign exchange risks and inflation risks. But analogous projects are not yet available in the digital asset space and are unlikely to become available anytime soon. By the other turn, if you don't use your native token for revenue capture, how is its value going to be coupled to service use fundamentals? Continuing on these themes, how exposed are your revenues to speculative sentiment? Even if you haven't built a project that's narrowly designed to thrive on speculation, it's really important to have a risk perspective on how your revenues will respond in a market downturn. If your tokenomics redistributes value to fund other business processes or reward agents who are critical to the market or economy, how sustainable are these value flows? Are they properly budgeted for on fiscal terms? Do they incentivize agents strongly enough? Do they have any monetary interactions or consequences, and are those sustainable? How does all of this funding scale with the user base or their activities? And again, how do all these factors respond to changes in market sentiment? Lots of revenue-related questions here, but there's even more when we start looking to treasury management. First, we know that blockchain startups will typically hold reserves of their native tokens as assets that are available to finance a variety of activities. Options for the management and deployment of these treasury assets depend heavily on how revenues are structured, since ideally, ongoing operational activities are funded out of revenues, not treasury token holdings. Unfortunately, this is something that many founders miss. What market makers and liquidity managers have you hired to facilitate treasury actions? What goals have you set for them? This is highly important, since the ability to liquidate treasury tokens will depend on market conditions. How are good market conditions capitalized on? And how are you planning to set aside stable value reserves for key long-term goals and expected one-off expenses? How can you structure over-the-counter deals to limit impacts to circulating supply while funding growth goals for the project? Are rewards and agent incentive payouts from the treasury commensurate with the value they create or bring in? How do treasury holdings and financial reserves and budgets stand up to a change in market conditions? Now, I know I've just reeled off a whole bunch of questions here, and each one of these deserves to be unpacked and explored in its own right. But hopefully this is enough to get you started and to help you to see how important and deeply entwined tokenomic matters can become to the financial management of a business. Accordingly, it will often be necessary for business plan and tokenomic development to occur in tandem with each other, especially as investors become more focused on examining revenue generation and the wider business model during less ebullient phases of the business cycle. And even if you've hired your tokenomics experts to create a design during the pre-launch phase, their design should make an effort to take into account financial management concerns and reduce the risks and simplify the tasks that are going to be faced by the incoming CFO and her team. It may be the case that you need more than one tokenomics expert to achieve this, since we're beginning to see some differentiation of talent between those that offer deep, narrow services for mechanism testing that's rooted in statistical simulation and computer-aided design, and other tokenomic experts that are equipped to develop less technical features, but in the context of a more holistic and integrated business perspective. So, wrapping up for today, I hope that this helps give you an introduction to the ways in which running a tokenized business can be different, and specifically, how tokenomic matters can become a crossover concern in various key business functions, intertwining with product, sales and marketing, and above all, with finance. The exact nature of what you will have to pay attention to will vary depending on your circumstances, but just make sure you are working with tokenomic advisors who can provide you with perspectives on these issues because, as we have seen, they can have immense importance to your business status as a going concern.